In Albertville, the ladies' original program, one-third of the total score. The Americans have already skated tonight. Christy Yamaguchi, flawless. She is in first place. Nancy Kerrigan, flawless. She is in second place. Tanya Harding, a missed combination on the triple axel, but she still is in third. And Yuka Sato, who was the first skater tonight, is fourth. Nancy Kerrigan was the first, by luck of the draw, to skate tonight, Scott.
And she couldn't have done this combination any better. Look at the height of this triple Lutz. A lot of flow coming out. Easy double toe loop.
And her mother, Brenda, who is legally blind, watched that combination and reacted with great excitement to Nancy Kerrigan's performance. For Tanya Harding, a little bit of a different story tonight.
She's so athletic. The height of the triple axel is unbelievable. When you tilt it backwards, there is absolutely no human possible way to save the landing. Cost 0.5 off the score.
Christy Yamaguchi, the third from the United States to skate.
A little forward on the landing of this triple Lutz, but there's absolutely no problem, no deduction. The strength of her artistry put her in first place.
And on the ice right now, midway through the 6-minute warm-up period. And again, these skaters are determined by luck of the draw, the order in which they skate. Midori Ito.
Well, she's been struggling all day with a triple axel, and it looks to me like she's warming up triple Lutz. When you miss something, you got to stay in it. Just stay in the competition. You got to be top three in order to have control over your destiny in the long program. But today in practice, a little sideshow going on. Backflips are illegal in competition, and Saria Bonaly does it right into triple toe loop. And the only problem was Midori Ito was in the middle of a run-through. A little bit of a problem there. Midori might have been distracted. The crowd went crazy. But in her run-through, she went around to do triple axel, and I think she was a little intimidated, a little overwhelmed, and all she could pull off was a single. Now, in every practice, there's always a little gamesmanship going on. I'm sure Saria didn't mean to get in her way. She's in her home country. She's in France, and she wanted to light up the crowd during the practices. These practices have been well attended. It did cause a little bit of a stir, a bit of controversy.
Well, Midori Ito just about has completed her warm-up. And the question is, will she try the triple axel? Will she go for the Lutz instead?
If I were a coach with the problems she had on the triple axel today, I'd say play it smart. You want to stay in the competition. You know that Tanya Harding missed the triple axel. You can be top three and be in control of your own destiny with a clean, short program. So if I were the coach, take the triple axel out. You don't need the risk. Stay in the top three. Do the triple Lutz, a jump that she does very easily.
Midori Ito practicing the triple Lutz, it appeared, one more time. Will it be the axel or the Lutz? Midori Ito will be on the ice when we return to Albertville.
The ladies' figure skating competition continues now on the Olympic Winter Games on CBS.
We're back at the Olympic Ice Hall in Albertville. The women's original program is underway. Midori Ito still to skate. Midori's a national hero in Japan. Because of that, she's been bombarded by media attention. The Japanese network that's covering this event signs off every evening with an update on the Yamaguchi-Ito battle. I talked to her team leader today to find out how they're dealing with all the extra attention. He said they're not allowing any interviews until after today's original program. Midori Ito is a very shy and gentle person. This morning on practice, she was surrounded by cameras. She was missing her combination. And I think all of the extra attention is taking its toll.
Christie's in first. Midori has warmed up. And the question is, will it be the triple axel or will it be the Lutz combination? We're about to find out. Midori Ito from Nagoya, Japan.
She's revolutionized women's figure skating. The first woman ever to do triple axel in competition. And this preparation will tell us which combination she's going for. She's going for the triple Lutz. Triple Lutz, and she cannot even hang on to that. 0.5 deduction. These competitions are as mental as they are physical. She has been hounded by the press. She hasn't had one moment's concentration. And in the last few days, it's really shown up in her skating.
And now, instead of battling Christy Yamaguchi for the top spot, or indeed Nancy Kerrigan for number two, she might be fighting Tanya Harding for third position.
Well, Tanya Harding at least went for the triple axel. That's a much more difficult jump. The judges will reflect that in their marks. The triple Lutz isn't as hard as a triple axel, so her base mark should be lower than Tanya's. Christy to lose this competition.
But a heartbreak for the young woman from Nagoya, who has warmed the hearts of the skating world. So has she, for that matter, Christy Yamaguchi.
And you can see it on both of their faces. Christy knows how it feels, and she's got to feel really badly for Midori. I know that Christy wants this to be a head-to-head battle, and she wants both skaters, herself and Midori, to skate their best. This is a jump she does easily in practice. She'll vault with the right foot. Look at the height she gets, the rotation. She never has a problem with that jump, ever. I think it's one of the first times I've ever seen her fall in the triple Lutz.
Might the indecision as to which jump to attempt have gone into that?
It really plays a big factor. When I go to competition, I want to know what I'm doing. I rarely change because you get into a flow and a rhythm of the choreography. You take the same amount of crossovers, you take the same edge into the same corner, and it's consistency. When you change things the day of the competition, even if it's easier, sometimes it just doesn't work out.
Oh boy, the first set of marks from Midori Ito.
And for her, she has to be devastated. She is probably the greatest woman jumper of all time. Her jumps didn't show up today. Let's take another look at the fall on the triple Lutz. Now she gets in the air fine, but watch her right foot on the way down, her landing foot. Looks like she catches a heel, and there's no way you can hang on to the landing. And as a skater, it's very painful to watch.
Here are the second set.
And these are generous, 5'8". She's not a great artistic skater. Tanya skates a little more fire than she does, but those are going to be enough to beat Tanya Harding and put her in the top three for a head-to-head competition in the long program with Nancy Kerrigan and Christy Yamaguchi. Very generous marks.
Interesting now, though, Scott, that 8 of the 9 judges placed her third in the original program. Scott, all 9 judges saw Ito's performance tonight better than Tanya Harding's.
Well, I would have given Tanya the higher mark because she did go for the triple axel combination. She took the risk. She should be rewarded for it. It's a tougher combination. But from the judge's point of view, I think it comes down to this. It takes a long time to judge 2.5 minutes of skating. It starts in practices. It's like a record album. You buy a record, it takes you a long time to get used to the words and the music. The more you listen to it, the more you understand it. In skating, it's the same way. The judges come to practices all week. Midori's been skating great until the last couple of days. Tanya came in very late. She's only been here a couple of days, and she really hasn't put together a good practice. So I'm sure in the judge's eyes, Midori was better coming into the competition.